Hey guys. You know, our knowledge of knots is really only as good as our ability to put them to practical use. So as I show the knots in these series, if you know of some uses for some of these knots that I haven't covered, feel free to share them in the comments. Let's get everybody on the same page, and you might have some uses that I don't know about, so it'd be really nice to learn from you also. As a certified animal packer and former Marine Corps mountaineer, I know the value of a good knot. I'm Norseman, and this is What Knot to Do. The first knot we're gonna tie today is something called the sheet bend. It's named the sheet bend because that's how they used to bend the sheets to a line or tie the sails to a line on a sailing ship. Whenever you secure two ropes together, it's called a bend. So technically a square knot is a bend, a sheet bend, there's carrick bends and other kind of bends, but if it says bend, it's specifically designed to connect two lines together. So the sheet bend gets its name because it was originally used to tie sheets to lines. And you would bend the sheet, pass the line around and back under itself. That's your basic sheet bend. Something else interesting is that the sheet bend is the same knot that you'll see securing the rope head stall to a horse or a mule. The difference is both ends come through instead of just one. So let's see this POV. I'm gonna make a bite in the line. Then I'm gonna take this piece and come up the middle, over, and back under itself. There's my sheet bend. A variation, I give a little more tail and I go around one more time. And now I have a double sheet bend. And the beauty of this knot is it's specifically designed to tie two unlike materials together. So tying a sheet to a line or tie a large line to a small line or something of that nature. So here's an example of unlike materials. We're gonna give that a bend. Go around and under itself, and then we'll do that one more time for the double. Once we draw it down tight, dress it up. As long as there's tension on this line, it's not going anywhere. Now, as with most knots, you can make this slippery, they call it, by instead of passing the tag end under, we're gonna go ahead and pass a bite under. And now it's a slippery sheet bend because all I have to do is pull that to release it. Now that knot, the slippery sheet bend, is what they use for a tail tie when you have to tie the lead rope of one horse to the tail of another horse. This is useful if you just had a crash and all your little piggins broke and you have to lash everyone back together in the right order and then go through and repair your line. Vets use the tail tie in order to remove a tail or hide it up out of the way so they can do vet work or give birth or whatever they're doing. There's a lot of reasons why you would want to tie up a horse's tail or a mule's tail or a cow's tail. But the importance of that knot is that it can be used to tie a tail-like substance to your line. Now, I don't actually have a horse, but I do have a unicorn and I borrowed her tail. Whoa, oh girl, that's okay. I'm gonna lay the lead rope across the tail. Then I'm gonna bend the tail. Then I'm gonna bend the tail. I'm gonna bring this up over my thumb, around the back, and I'm gonna create a bite and just slide that bite right up underneath that tag. Once I draw it down tight, the unicorn is secure until I release her. So a great use that would make you want to have a sheet bend in your mental toolkit is if you ever need to build a shelter and all you have are old curtains, maybe a wool blanket, maybe some plastic tarp or a space blanket, something with no eyelets that you can't really poke holes and tie into, the double sheet bend is your best friend. We'll hope you get some use out of the many variations of the sheet bend. Hopefully you have a good opportunity to put it to use if you ever need to hitch up your unicorn. And if you liked that, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to ring that bear bell, and I'll see you on the trail.